What it is, good people, what is happening, happy new year, all that good stuff. Wait, was it? I'll definitely stream this year. Yep. Whatever, happy new year anyway. Just take the compliment. Anywho, what it is, what it ain't, where it go, where I, how I get there, and why is it over there? It is your boy, Dead No A. This is No A Gaming, and I am playing Alan Wake Remastered of this good game. Let me share to my good folk that I'm playing. Please bear with me. Share with my Twitch familia, Twitch. Oh yeah, my Twitch family, my Discord family, same thing really. To be completely real. Yeah, man. Hope this new year, I should say, has been all right for you so far. Little slight announcement, your boy has registered and been accepted into school at Full Sail University. I will be taking up creative writing on the associate's degree side, just because I want to get a feel of what's going on before I dive headfirst into a full bachelor's degree. But in case y'all didn't know, I am a published author already. Life Sentence on Amazon and Amazon Kindle. Life Sentence by Dedrick Williams. Go look that up. I didn't go to school for writing, so I'm not the best at it. Or I should say, as far as the marketing side, I'm pretty decent at writing. But as far as the marketing side goes, I'm not that great. So this is going to help me out a lot. And I'm working on a second book as well. So this is going to help me with that second book. We are in the horror genre because I like horror stuff. Let's go ahead and jump into this game. So yeah, very excited about that. Can't wait to start. Now, if you were with me on episode one, I started this on the Xbox. But I didn't realize that I already downloaded it on PS5. Now, for me, this feels way better on PS5 than it does on the Xbox. So, with that being said, I will be continuing this game on the PS5. Excuse me, it actually looks better on the PS5 too. PS5 as well. There we go. So, yeah, that. Alright, let's dive into this thing. I ain't got to tell you what happened last week because they about to tell you anyway. Previously on Alan Wake. It's like watching a TV show. Let me turn this light off. My wife, Alice. Thank you for coming here with me. Maybe you could write here. I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice. Now, she's missing. Alice? I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared. Taken. So for those of you who don't know, these enemies that I am fighting are called the Taken. They are possessed beings, I assume. What the hell? They are possessed beings, I assume.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Cool. Is that why I'm seeing?
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
There you go. The coffee things. All over the place. Or collecting the coffee. The coffee joints are collectibles. There we go. We just moved here. This most clearly is a flashback. So we check you out. I can play with both headphones on now. Return to Cinder. Alex Casey Thriller. I should get a fake author name. Huh. If you'll excuse me, I'll be checking this QR code. See what they do for me. It's a YouTube video.
The dark place was an endless waking dream. I saw visions carried by the ebb and flow of different dream states. Them in my writing to make it real so that the parts that weren't would become so. And there were visions that I knew were not real, ideas I had lost, often of Casey. I had written about him for years. I used them as well.
Oh, hey, I just
the
finished this cover.
I'm kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
Even before.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Thinking they were mine.
Oh, really?
Well, you seemed to think so last night.
This says vision number 2, so I presume that I missed the first one in the first episode. I also just learned that there are only 6 episodes to this game. Oh, this is going to be short. I have a desk somewhere. Where is it? I guess that's what there.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called.
Oh, shit.
Alan? Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry!
All right, damn. Oh.
I'm right here, baby.
I'm fine, I'm fine. Just get the lights back on. Now, please.
I'm actually glad that happened because I was tired of that static sound. Fuse box should be here, I guess.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry. We'll just break out the candles.
I know it's stupid, but it's just... especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you too.
Yeah, nice story, writer boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar.
Wow.
Thanks for this.
Oh, whoa, whoa, this is a family channel. No freaky stuff, thank you.
Hmm. How do you feel, Mr. Wake? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm okay. My head's fine.
Damn, he is a liar, huh?
My headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
Hmm. Sounds like an affair waiting to happen. Am I wrong to assume? Maybe. Do I care? Well, if you know me. No, I don't care. Just in case you didn't know. Okay.
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
This woman.
Be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
What am I reading? What am I reading? Oh. Who is this? Have you seen this man disappeared on June 20th of 2007? And I graduated that year. Identifying features, knack for winning contests. Oh. It's a missing cat and two other missing fellows. They were on a camping trip. Hmm. Interesting.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Appreciate it. I will circle back to that. Don't want to do that yet. And she's gone.
Mr. Wake, the sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
Am I allowed back
that
here?
That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
Wow.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that.
Hmm. None of that is like a clue?
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. Yeah, this is Thornton. Look, we've located the parade float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsals today. Over.
Oh, give me that. Mulligan here. Looks like someone really thrashed the garage. Over.
Okay, roger that, guys. Keep looking for Stuckey. Jane's out.
Hmm. Crazy.
The sheriff wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
Gee, thank you. The same cat? Yep. Alright, we'll holler at the sheriff now.
Your phone, Mr. Wake?
I'm here. Give me a second. Let me look around.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake? How did you end up at Stuckey's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me. I need to take this. Hello?
Alice, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here.
Mm-mm, don't you do it.
If you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal.
Mr. Wake, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor.
Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the light? The light's on! The deputies, they don't understand. They won't listen to me. I need it to be bright in here.
So multiple people are talking about darkness and nobody gives a damn. I feel that. While we're here though.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. memory of my corpse.
What?
Alone at my own wake, thinking in metaphors again. The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
This was
a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me. It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red, a gruesome slushy, dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
Okay.
In spite of its human mask, to describe the dark presence as intelligent would have implied human qualities on something decidedly inhuman. Nonetheless, it found the one spot in the diner that was dark enough. Some light spilled into the corridor, ravaging it. But it took the pain. Ryder would soon fix that. He would be coming to the one place where it still had power.
That's weird. All right, while I'm searching for stuff,
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache. The man on the phone had said, go through the fence on the left.
But I want to check stuff out on the right.
Well, folks, it's been another long night, and it's about time for me to sign off for a while. God knows I need my beauty sleep. Just one more item before I go. It's been a busy night for the sheriff's department. We've had a few broken windows, even a report of shots fired on Main Street. Deputies Mulligan and Thornton had to deal with two intoxicated young men who were celebrating the completion of their Deer Fest float. Now, folks, we get this every year. I know it's exciting, the big day is almost here, but let's save it for the party and leave the gunplay for the shooting competition, huh? There's no point in getting all worked up yet.
That ain't suspicious.
The caller had told me to find a hole in the fence behind the police station. There was something for me in an abandoned car.
There's a hole. There's a ladder. I'll probably have to drop that later.
The kidnapper fired his gun one last time, and the shadow vanished into the darkness it had come from. See? Nothing to it, Wake. The thought of Alice in his hands was revolting. We stood on the wooden platform of Lover's Peak, the waterfall in the mountain behind us, the lights of the radio mast blinking red in the heights above. I fought with the urge to take a swing, forced myself to speak. Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
One button. All right.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat. The caller meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Barry, listen to me. I'm at the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow! What the hell is going?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed to get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Yeah, that's about to happen.
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Oh no, he's asleep. All right, bet.
Marvelous, Sarah. I just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently
inadvertently caused on their recent regrettable outing.
They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been...
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman.
I'd like
to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Dang, cuz.
Oh, my.
Take it easy.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
We ain't got to the action yet.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park. The plan was to rent a cabin.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Normally, yeah.
Barry, you found him.
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
Weird.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
He's talking about his outfit choice.
What an airhead.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan. She even has a fan site dedicated to you.
Is it Willie Mammoth? Yep.
Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car, just listen to yourself.
These doors, I don't like this angle.
What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared?
That's what he said.
When was the last time you slept? Are you high? Have you been drinking?
That'd be great.
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week. And someone's got Alice.
Do you
and everything's just...
understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong. It's a good story. Could be a bestseller.
But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
Wait here.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure.
From who?
What happened?
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is going to be okay. He got lucky.
Right, right.
Max is still groggy from the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone.
You can't just go and meet a kidnapper. Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
Charlie.
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole thing, listen, you hit your head. I mean, geez, Al, come on.
You gotta understand how crazy all this sounds. If you're trying to pull a joke on me, freak me out, it's working. Ha ha, let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now.
I think this is the form you wanted.
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Appreciate that. Thanks.
Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
I think that's where all the... No pun intended. I think that's where all the action's gonna be at.
Look, Al. You're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went... into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a flashlight at him. You hear that from people who end up spending time in padded rooms, strapped to their beds, wearing white shirts with too long tangled up sleeves, and eating a healthy diet of pills. Al, you make cruel jokes about people who believe that kind of stuff. You're the skeptic. You gave me an hour-long lecture on homeopathy last month. What was it? If there's no proof, it's pure bullshit. Period.
Guess the laugh's on me then.
Al, come on! I mean, okay. Okay, maybe something weird happened to you, okay?
Well, thanks for the heartfelt vote of confidence.
All I'm saying is you gotta throw me a bone here, bestseller. What would you think if it was me? There's no way you should be going out at midnight with a gun.
No one asked you to come here, Barry. Either work with me on this or go straight back to New York. Your choice.
Mm-hmm. I should have took a nap instead of streaming. Okay, instead of streaming. But I'm here. I'm here. We're going to ride this episode out. And I'm going to make my runs and I'm going to come back and pass on the couch, hopefully.
We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her.
This wow. is not a goddamn debate, Barry.
Who's he?
I'm going to Lover's Peak. He said to come alone.
Okay, okay then. I understand. You're my best friend and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help and I'll do it.
You stay here and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
Achoo!
Yeah, the dealers too.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These or it'll be deliverance all over again.
So we just tripping and falling down steps. Let's keep it on. Locked. Guess we're going out the front door. Alright. This is the back door. Okay. What is this? Yeah, I don't know what it is. Oh, look, more crows. Okay. Yeah. Jacuzzi popping. Wow, foot.
I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Lock the door now.
Quick. Hey, I ain't got none of the guns. I guess because that was the prologue. Alright. That's the whip. That's the manuscript.
Barry had never gotten along with Alice, but he knew Alan loved her with an almost frightening intensity. And now something had happened to Alice. And here was Al armed with a gun and saying things people got put in padded cells for. It was as if his friend had experienced a massive psychotic episode and was now totally disconnected from reality. It scared the shit out of Barry. I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Logical thinking, okay.
Show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio. Doc,
let's go.
What's your Deerfest plan like?
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage.
Ooh, that scared me just a lot of it.
No plan, really. Just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know.
Oh, tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
Yes, exactly, Pat. But I'm gonna check out the parade, of course. And I'll be one of the pie contest judges, too.
Well, that takes a different kind of constitution.
Oh, yeah, it's my kind of exercise.
Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors type. I know for a fact you're an avid fisherman.
That's right. Matter of fact, just caught a heck of a largemouth bass early this morning.
But you're not taking part in the fishing contest?
No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that competitive anymore. Now I just like to take my time and enjoy the peace of it. It's no fun if I need to worry about what I'm catching, you know?
Well, considering your track record, the participants are probably pretty happy you feel that way.
Well, Pat, that's kind of you to say.
So if I go down the steps too quick. Oh, shit. All right. That was a good one. Moving on, if I go down the steps too quick, I will trip down them, apparently, as it has happened on more than one occasion. Okay. Okay. Yep, figured. What's that show again? We won't stick around for that.
Rose knew that Rusty was in love with her, and she liked him too. She liked him a lot. He taught her to dance, and life had seen the unbearable truth. She was no closer to that Hollywood magic than he was.
Rusty was a cop, I think. That was at the bar.
Visitor center was heavy with an awful smell, as if some rotten drowned thing had crawled up from its grave. Rusty kept coughing blood. My eyes were drawn to the twisted shape of his broken leg. The attack had been vicious. Max whined in his cage. Rusty's eyes were wild with fear and terror.
Yeah,
he gasped.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it happened just the way it was on that page.
Perhaps he's running to the man.
The visitor center was sturdy, but the impact turned the front of the building into splinters. Rusty was thrown across the lobby like a rag doll and hit the far wall hard. It didn't hurt until he tried to move and saw his leg bend the wrong way. Felt the broken rib stabbing him on the inside.
Okay.
Rusty howled in pain and fear, suddenly afraid to die alone. The ranger's office was locked. I'd need a key to get in.
Sure, Rusty has said key.
Hello?
I'm back here.
Mr. Wake?
Oh, hell.
It happened just the way it was on that page. I found. Came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights. In the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back. Whatever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what it
happened. Oh, God. Look at his leg.
Shh. Good boy.
It's cool, old Yeller. We got it. Okay. Start out, Chip.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on.
Probably running around here, waiting to be scared the shit out of. If y'all missed episode 1, you can check my YouTube, No Egg Gaming. I'm sure the link is on my page somewhere. To the channel. Go peep that.
At the last instant, I changed direction and threw myself down. The axe splintered the trunk of a tree. I stumbled into the pool of bright light. My lungs burned. I was too exhausted to move. I tensed as I waited for the killing blow, but it never came. I raised my head. Nothing moved in the darkness beyond. For the moment, bathed in the cold light, I was safe.
All right, so that's about to happen soon. any batteries, so...
I was too late. Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
Damn, he did.
Was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness.
Name is a little trash there.
Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
I'm gonna assume the mammoth? Oh. The mammoth is here.
Please! Don't feed the animals! Fishing! Bridges up, Mark. Fishing. License!
Oh. Oh, that boy fast. High for me, boy. Got him. Oh, there's more. All right, bro. Missed. Back up for me. Appreciate that. Appreciate it.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
I manuscript page.
In that last instant of consciousness, Rusty thought about Rose. He was older than she was. Rose was barely out of her teens, but she made him feel young and forget what a train wreck his long dead marriage had been.
Damn.
He still wore the ring. He'd been waiting for her to tell him to take it off. Now she never would. Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
I thought I saw a silhouette of an animal. Like, wait, what is that? Moonshine Cave. I thought those were footsteps. All right, so there's a rifle, shotgun, and some flares. Let's go. This cave was the site of a frequent liquid bootlegger. Oh, okay. Alright, we won't move too fast. I got a feeling. Only two. Oh, I never saw that one. Cool, we appreciate that. It's necessary. Am I gonna have to fight that big Willy Mammoth? Willy Mammoth, whatever you wanna call it. Alright. Miss. Oh shit. Where the fuck you come from? Oh. Cool. Get those things. Did not want to use that right then, but I was outnumbered. That's cool. We'll keep fresh. Am I going the right way? Yeah, I think I am. Okay. Expecting to come up on one of these.
Bright Falls seemed to know where Al was, but Rose, the waitress at the diner, had seen him. From what Barry could tell, Al pretty much fell off the face of the earth when he left the diner. Rose was just the kind of fan that Al hated, but she really tried to help. She was smart, too. Knew a lot about what was going on in the town. Knew a lot about Al. Even knew who Barry was. Barry liked her. That was no big surprise. When it came to women, Barry and Al rarely saw eye to eye.
Imagine. Oh. Look like a doorway. It ain't. Alright. Alright, where am I going? Upward, I guess. So this way. Oh, I don't like how this is turning out. Yes. Oh, I want to see it. But it's probably not best to read anything while you're getting attacked. My God, almost got me there. And we're running. I definitely said running. And I'm dead. All right. Wait, come back. Where'd you go? Everyone else. Ooh. Miss. Miss. Ah, you got me. Damn, what the hell? Nice try. I'm out. That boy is booging it. Wow, where'd you come from? Back up for me, thanks. Oh, oh yep. Couldn't move. Whew. Needed all of that. Yeah, we get on the health of school. I'm sure I ran past something. Good grief. Something else. Useful. There's 100 of these little things, by the way. Will I get all 100? Absolutely not. I'm not even that dedicated. If I see it, I'm gonna grab it. Yep, manuscript page.
I turned the corner, afraid of what the flashlight's beam might reveal. Suddenly, a roughly painted symbol of a torch glowed in the light. Behind it, hidden by a rock, sat a battered metal trunk. It was here for a reason. Packed with supplies, batteries, flares, ammo. Things you need to make it through the darkness of the night. Something left behind by someone who knew what I knew, and more.
Okay. Great. Great, 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 great. What we got here? The Taken are filled with darkness. Imagine. Who would have thought? I gotta watch out for bears too. Oh, scared me. Jesus in the morning. Miss. Ooh, miss. Oh, okay, we missed that. Damn. All right. All right. That's wild. So that means I almost fell, number one. Number two is supplies somewhere. So it says that, whatchamacallit, Paige? I don't want to jump down. I'm going to end up over there. Alright. Get ready for this BS. Yeah, I saw y'all. Missed. Damn, that was just swift. What the f- Alright, cool. Don't worry about the big guy. Gotta get in the light. Well, where the hell? Okay. Not going to jump back over. Ready to go. I ran right to them. Crazy. Ran, nigga. Oh, God. Okay, okay. Block.
Agent Nightingale didn't want to be in Bright Falls. These little communities revolted him, and he didn't like the trees or the coffee. He now knew that impossible horrors lurked behind the storefronts and smiles. He desperately wanted to turn the car around and just drive until he passed out or ran out of road and booze. But he had a job to do. He had a rider to catch, at any cost.
Mm-hmm. Aw, man. Oh, I'm done it now. fudge was that? Oh. Light right there, so he's not coming from behind me.
Flashlights, kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
Appreciate it.
You can see them too?
Hell, of course I see them. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice. He knew my name. We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
Come on, wait. Better keep up. Hear that? It's them.
Can I run out? Sure, gotta go. Don't run for me.
Lover's Peak, right up these stairs, Wake. Use the flares from the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun!
No time for back talk.
Meanwhile, I didn't use I don't know how many. I don't know what it is. I'm out.
That's right. Oh, you feeling better now, Wake? All cozy and safe.
Wow.
Better get ready. They'll be on us soon. This is it, Wake. The last stand. There's more players here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun! They're coming!
That's not how this goes. Get with the program.
Do that, thanks. I missed one too. Oh! Wow, what the hell? Back up. Wow, having more flares. Shoot him, nigga, what are you doing? Oh my god.
Last stand.
I hate it here.
Flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake. That's right. You just keep coming.
Definitely did that by accident. It's two more left. There we go. Biggins. Oh, hey. I knew I was going to get hit. Please give me a checkpoint. Don't make me do it all over again. All over again.
Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes.
Three waves, four flares. Closer they are, easier they are here. Feel free to shoot him. Thank you. head and cousin. So I'm here fighting for my fucking life. Oh my god, yep. Kinda like that.
Last stand. There's more flares here. Get ready.
Our compadre will not give me a gun for whatever reason. Gun.
They're coming. That's not how this goes. Get with the program.
Gotta fight for your life. Oh my god. I'm cooling. Had a day off today. But you know. How you feeling? Whooping is not even the word, but we'll use that. And I ain't got no help. Thank you. Oh man. I feel that. I hope you feel better. Definitely get that rest in there, because that is necesito. Woo! Okay. Appreciate you stopping in as well. I gotta catch up with you and Queen on COD, because I missed the last session. Nobody likes me being great around this place. Oh wait, big one. Oh no, baby. There he is. Whoa, went right to him. Right fucking to him. Thank you. That was both of them? That was not. I'm stuck. Back up. Thanks. Sound like a move to me.
Let's cut the act now. Where's my wife?
I knew you were gonna say that. I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
What the hell are you talking about? Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript, or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her off.
Damn, cuz. Finally got strapped.
Alice had tried to explain to me how it felt to be afraid of the dark. To her, darkness wasn't simply the absence of light, but something more tangible than that. It was something you could touch and feel. Worse than that, it was something with a mind of its own, something malicious and malign. For her, things changed when they were wrapped in darkness. They turned into something else, something foreign, and nothing was safe or innocent anymore. I'd never really understood what she meant until now.
Yeah. Usually how that goes. I missed the canister because I kept dying.
He wanted the manuscript because he thought it held some magical power. But I had no manuscript to give him. I had to get back to Barry and figure out my next move.
Well, the thing about that is somebody's been writing. And if it ain't you, then who? No other weapon. Oh shit. Thought it was something I could use. Damn if her name bear traps to kill my ass. Alright, avoid, avoid, avoid. Smart bastards, I hate you. Alright. Damn it! Am I? Nope. Careful, careful, careful. So we can't just simply run through the woods here. Okay, we got something here. All right, useful. Thank you for your time. Something ain't right. Run, nigga, run. Okay. All right. Okay. So I can't sprint for too long. So man has an asthma problem. Thank you. Damn. Was a headshot. Yep, saw that coming. Oh, and I'm stuck. This. Oh, easy. Cool. What's in here? Yep, definitely missed one already, but it's whatever. Look like a...
The night had been one desperate situation after another. I was exhausted, and my body felt as though it had been chewed up and spat out. The flashlight was heavy in my hand, and each pull of the trigger sent a painful shock up my arm. But I was finally out of the woods, and things were looking up. That's when I heard the chainsaw.
Wow. Oh, wait a minute.
I had heard the plane fall. It made no sense. It was clear that it had just fallen here, but it was very old and obviously hadn't flown in decades. Looking at it sent a shiver down my spine.
So are we going to it? Dang, where is it, Arrow? What was that? All right, cool. Showing me something. I don't know what. Was it this rock? That rock. Okay. There's like something's up there though. And flare gun. That's a long way down, I was about to say, yeah. Oh, look, a flare. First of all, oh wait, wrong gun, dang it. Thank you. Guess I'm going to the house. Oh, right in my forehead. Oh, hello? Thank you. At the same time, huh? Okay. Careful. All right. Definitely not what I did. But cool. Why not? What keeps hitting me? Oh. Just like in life, I don't look down.
Site was a mess. The modular office had been pushed off the cliff. Deputy Thornton climbed up from the wreckage excited, breathing hard from the exertion. Nobody there. It's weird. Don't you think that's weird? Bored, Mulligan let out a mighty snort. Hell, it's always weird, Thornton. Just a question of sorting out what kind of weird it is this time around.
Excuse me. Nowhere else? Okay. Moving forward. I forgot about that rifle, excuse me. Kick.
When Barry saw the darkness attack the visitor center, it made him a believer. The men Al said he'd shot, they hadn't been just locals on crank. Somehow the world had changed, like the channel had been switched without warning. You think you're watching a sitcom, and you're really watching a horror show. When the birds started attacking the cabin, Barry wasn't surprised, just terrified.
Speaking of, are we supposed to be checking on Barry? Or something of that nature? Alright, it's dark around here. To the cabin.
Be aware of the oil makers.
darkness wears her face. Weird. Wonder who her is in this scenario. I would assume his wife, now that I say that out loud. Okay. There we go. Oh, got enough revolver ammo? Oh shit, watch out. Here, but wait. Oh, okay, there you are. Two of them, huh? Hold that for me. Damn. Wow. Yep. So when the sprint button doesn't work. The chainsaw. Shouldn't I use that on you? Too easy. I do have it on the normal mode. Ah, we're good. Let's get right with Barry. In this episode, I got things to do.
So just make sure you keep the lights on. I still had to reach Barry at the cabin, but at least I was out of the woods.
Great. Okay. Let's have the light. Got a feeling I'm gonna be chased.
To get the car from the locked garage, it would get me back to Barry faster, and the headlights were a welcome bonus.
Mm-hmm. Oh, manuscript.
The FBI agent's command froze me in place. I considered surrender. It was all falling apart anyway. I could give in, let someone else deal with it. But it felt all wrong. Call it instinct, his posture, the way he held the gun. He was no friend. Shots ringing in my ears, I leaped for the hole in the fence and stumbled into the darkness beyond.
Wow. Well, I got to go in there.
I had to find the key to the garage. A story is not a machine that does what you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own. You can create it, shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
You can hold and yourself.
Some things you just know. But I don't have to drive, and I do. All right. For me to get stuck. Let's restart from the checkpoint. Shit, where's Barry? They didn't take me out of the car yet, so I guess I gotta keep going.
The flare gun was probably the best weapon I could imagine against the dark things I was facing.
Oh. Probably should have searched that cabin.
It was the kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake. You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need... a week.
Not done?
I need a week.
2 days! The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. If not, well, get me.
Yes, yes, I get you.
It's not even Alice. Guarantee is Rose.
Barry had talked about birds over the phone.
The darkness controls the Taken. We know that. Reload the weapon. I still got... Nope, I use it all. Alright. Oh man, oh man. Alright, 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 alright. Reload, reload. Oh, you're not gonna open the door. Okay. Crazy.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back.
Ah!
For me, the supernatural had always been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now, it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
That didn't sound weird.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon. Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Oh, she ain't even taken. Well, that is a good setup for episode 3, which we make us halfway through the game.
Come here. Pretty
please. And I'm going to keep it pushing because I'm sure there's going to be a copyright strike on YouTube for this. I'll have them cut it out. Anywho, I appreciate everybody that came through. Appreciate my cousin Soleil popping in, actually saying words. Man, this has been Dead No A on No A Gaming, on the No A Gaming channel. And of course, I'm Dead No A. I will see y'all next time I stream. It'll probably be next week, because that's how my schedule is going to be. All right, anywho, I'm out. Y'all have a good one.